Port Moody is a small town that if you blink, you might miss the whole thing. But as always, there are hidden gems within. Port Moody today is known as the City of the Arts, but it owes everything to this railroad that put this on the map over 100 years ago.
My name is Marcus Farner. I'm a curator manager here at the Port Moody Station Museum. The mission is to conserve and promote heritage. You know, you don't work in a place like this and don't like it.
On a lonesome railroad line.
Because of Colonel Richard Moody, we have the railway, because initially people said, well, you can't build a railway through the mountains. So he came with the Royal Engineers to British Columbia. And he said, no, I've seen a railway in Europe being built through the Alps. So he was instrumental in serving the where the railway should be set up. There is no record that he actually came here. But I think some of his men recommended that this little town should be named in his honor. So Port Moody is named after Colonel Richard Moody. Yes, it's a very special building. It's built in 1908. Certainly one heart of the community. Everything that would arrive in Port Moody, you know, you order the piano in England, it'll be packed on a train, it'll delivered here. Every letter that got here, well, got delivered to the train station. This is where everything arrives. So I think it would be a hub because it's the information hub. Very crucial place and probably quite lively as well, I could imagine, yeah. Passenger services, as I said, they sort of slow down relatively quickly. July the 1st, 1886, the first scheduled train arrives here. But everyone in Port Moody thought, or most people thought, this is going to be the terminus. Well, this would be Vancouver, this would be, you know, the Port Moody Canucks, you know, that kind of stuff. So a lot of people invest in land and are hoping this is it. So in 1886, I mentioned the first train arrives, 1887, they already extend the line all the way to Vancouver. So less and less trains come through. What really saved Port Moody is then that we had a lot of mills, like lumber. So that sort of the industrial base saved Port Moody from disappearing. There is a long history that brings people here, and it's a terrible thing if you, you know, lose that. You know, if you lose the grounding to history, you're not aware of what happened. Come down, don't stand in front of the doors, just come on in and have a look. Yeah.
While logging used to be the main industry, now when you hear Port Moody, craft breweries is what comes to mind. Here's a look at Port Moody's famous Brewer's Row.
My name is Nick Anderson. I'm one of the managers at the Bakery Brewing and Moody Ales. Moody Ales is a craft brewery focusing on some sessionable beers that are out of this world and pretty great. So here in Port Moody, we have a bunch of different things that make the whole brewery scene super unique. The first one is the fact that we have 5 breweries now, all within about 500 meters of each other. Starting with Yellow Dog, opened in 2014, and was Moody Ales that opened in 2014. And then a year after that was Twin Sales, and then Parkside, and then just recently, the Bakery Brewing where we are now, which opened in July of this year. Started off with 2 friends, 2 co-workers who just wanted to get out of the rat race, get out of the working at a cubicle and do something that they were passionate about. Adam and Dan decided to open up a brewery. They didn't know that Yellow Dog had the exact same idea a few doors down. It ended up being for the best because now we're a whole entity. Brewers Bro in itself is a big thing, but we didn't know this 5 years ago. When people say that they're gonna do the row, it's a challenge of stopping by at every one of the five breweries on the row and being able to have a drink at each one. And the whole point is to sample as many beers as you can. We see it as a fun little thing to do for tourists and for locals alike, and it's kind of neat. It's kind of neat to think that the breweries are a destination and that people come all the way. We've had people from the States, from Europe come down just specifically to do the row, just because it's the place to be. And that's kind of impressive.
In Port Moody, everyone loves a good hike, especially after a night at the Brewer's Rose. This local hiker not only has a passion for the outdoors, but also for riding. Let's see what she has to say.
Hi, I'm Sarah Lawler. I'm 20 years old. I live in Port Moody, BC, and I love hiking. When I was about 8 or 9, it just honestly just like caught, like took my breath away. And yeah, since then I've been going like at least every other week. I've been a writer for my whole life. One of the biggest challenges for writing is finding inspiration, but I definitely find inspiration on my hikes for sure. To hike in Port Moody is definitely the Crystal Falls. Just like, it's so stunning. There's usually like never any people around. Like, it's the best. It's just nostalgic for me. Like, definitely like going hiking with my friends there and like reliving those like good memories. Now I've been aspiring to do the West Coast Trail on Vancouver Island. I've been really working up to it, and I definitely think that when I graduate in 2020, I'll be able to do it, and it'll be like a gift to myself. It will definitely help me write. Something amazing is going to come out of it, I just know. And I'm very excited. To, you know, write a collection of poetry and stories, and hopefully, you know, get it published one day.
Some locals from Port Moody make it big. Take Julia Buds. She is a Bellator world champion and is aiming for her fifth win. Let's go check out her home grounds.
My name is Julia Budd. I'm the four-time Bellator females featherweight world champion. Thing martial arts, it's an amazing conditioning. It's such a fun workout, and you're never done learning. So you can do this for your entire life, and whenever you think you kind of reach a certain level and you're really good, then there's always somebody that will show you that you're still a beginner. I started coming out to Port Moody in 2001, I believe, to train. I grew up on the Sunshine Coast. I used to come in on the weekend on Saturdays, like when I was going through to high school, to come in here and spar and get training from the best in the world. I love it every time they announce me and my name on the world stage and they say I'm from Port Moody, British Columbia. It feels amazing. I mean, it's such a small community, and it's pretty cool. Basically, what I've learned over the years being a competitor in martial arts is that it's day by day. It's the little goals every day that I set for myself that eventually leads to big goals. For instance, today I knew I had to get my work done at 12 o'clock. It was about doing the best I could during that training session so that, I feel good at the end of the day and I know I put the work in.
I think my wife right now, after training her for so many years and winning so many world titles, that I'm confident in it, and I put everything I can into my wife. So, you know, that's even more than I would do for another fighter. So, you know, it's everything I put my blood, sweat, and tears into it. I'm confident.
It was definitely a little hard in the beginning, getting used to that and having to listen to him and figuring that way out in our relationship. But we've been together for so long now, so I think we've been together since like 2007. Our relationship's just grown stronger throughout this. So now it's amazing, but in the beginning it was definitely, there were some trying times where I was like, I'm not listening to you. And we get into fights and stuff. I'll be fighting again January 25th, 2020 for my fifth world title. This next fight of mine is the biggest of my career. It's against a really well-known female fighter who was the UFC champion, has come over, challenged me for my belt.
Well, this has been a long time coming. I was fighting back in the day when 15 years ago or 20 years ago, when there was no limits, no weight divisions, no time limits. And the sports evolved, and our name, Gibson name, is known throughout the world. And Julia, I need you and want you, and I know and totally believe in you that you're going to be the five-time world champion on January 25th and continue the legacy of our family name.
Working hard is a key ingredient for both Julia Budd and Karen Smetchers. As a flower shop owner, the busiest season is starting to roll in. As for Karen, the long working hours are curling in as well. Let's go see if she's a minute to spare.
My name is Karen Smetcher, and I am the owner of Port Moody Flowers. We've been at this location for about 6 years, and we design floral cuts, arrangements, potted, variety of different flowers. The business was started by Celia. I actually helped her open this place. She hired me, it was a part-time, and I really enjoyed the work. And after about a year, I ended up having my own business and starting my own thing, not in floral. And then about 5 years down the road, Celia was wanting to retire, and so she sold the business to me, and that was last year. And in the business, they carry a really talented crew that I'm very lucky to call, you know, my fellow worker bees, and you'll meet Suava, which is the head designer for the store.
My name is Suava, and I am the floral designer here at Port Moody Flowers.
My mom introduced me into floral design when I was out of high school and didn't really realize what I wanted to do. So we started off with some night courses, and then it led to me being a florist now for about 18 years.
For the fall season, and table arrangements are very, very popular, especially when people are having Thanksgiving dinner. They like to have a little floral. A lot of people like to give flowers. If they don't know what to bring for someone's dinner that, you know, maybe the hostess says, oh, don't worry, don't bring anything, they like to bring a little flowers. Or anything with the harvest themes, you know, the sunflowers, the burgundies, the deep colors, that is what is most popular right now. Well, one of the biggest challenges is how many other places do offer florals. There's a lot of places that offer florals, but they don't offer the design or the aesthetic or the years of experience making arrangements.
I find different challenges than Karen would. Getting your own inspiration to make arrangements and make pieces that other flower shops wouldn't offer. Supply and demand during hectic holidays would be one of those.
So that's our biggest challenge, is trying to keep with different designs, something that's more unique that you can find in the mass market. That is what keeps us one step ahead of mass floral companies. So, you know, we've been part of a community for a very long time with my family as well as with the business.
Everyone has their own passions, from flower arrangements to home decor. A local mom took her passion and made it into a business with the help of Instagram. Let's take a look at the behind the scenes of Dina's Digs.
My name is Dina and I live in Port Moody. I've lived here for 25 years. I'm passionate about home decor in a budget-friendly way through thrifting and DIYs. I've always been interested in thrifting since I was young. I love finding treasures and turning them into unique things for my home and for others. The woodworking is something fairly new to me that I've started in the past year. It started actually in my basement and was a disaster and a mess. So I built myself a workbench and a little workstation in my garage, and it's been really helpful. And that's where I work on all my projects. It started, first of all, with things I was finding at the thrift store and refinishing. Friends started wanting to buy my things, so I turned it into a small business in terms of the furniture refinishing part, and then started building items as well and selling those. Instagram has really helped, actually. I've just started on it recently. It's really helped connect people in the community and actually all around the world who have similar interests. They can help you out, lots of great suggestions. It's been super helpful, and actually a lot of sales come off Instagram as well. I don't have favorite things to thrift. Anything to me that I discover is super exciting. I actually get really excited when I find a neat treasure at the thrift store. I see a picture of something and I recreate it myself and put my own spin on it. My natural tendency is towards rustic, distressed finishes, and that just seems to be my natural style and what I like to do. I think everyone needs some form of creative outlet in their life, and for me, it's definitely the woodworking, furniture refinishing, painting, all of that.
Turning old to new is Dina's superpower, but there is another superhero here in Port Moody. Meet Simon. He is super strong, super fast, and can find any comic you will need. Even after 26 years, this place is still a hotspot for all the locals to hang out.
Hi, I'm Simon Chadwick. I own Hourglass Comics. Hourglass Comics is a comic and game store. It's been in Port Moody for 26 years. I'm the owner. I've had it since I was a teenager. We sell comic books, we sell games. We have customers that come in every Wednesday to pick up their comics. Wednesday is when new comics come out, and it becomes like a habitual, regular thing. Hang around and chat and get your stuff. A lot of our older stock comes from customers bringing collections in for us to appraise. We have had quite a few expensive comics. Mostly they don't last very long. Expensive comics are very highly collectible. We have a list of customers who will rush in the door that we phone and say we've got something good, and they come in and they usually buy it before it really sees the shelf. We sold recently a first appearance of Wolverine, which is Hulk 181. It was $1,200. In May, every year there's a free comic book day. We give away thousands of free comics on free comic book day. It's usually standing room only in here. A lot of kids have started reading from picking up comics here and grown up with it, and social groups that play games here too, and they get to meet new people, and sometimes people have built like long-lasting relationships from hanging out here. I went to BCIT for CAD, an engineering transfer program. I thought I'd be an engineer, but I didn't really enjoy it so much, so I bought a comic store, and just the rest is history, I guess.
Some superheroes can fly. Unfortunately, humans can't, but we can get pretty close with the use of drones. A Port Moody filmmaker, Bryce McGregor, can tell us all about it.
I think one of the biggest challenges for videographers and photographers is just getting out there for the first time. I hear so many people say they want to get into video, they want to get into taking photos, but they just don't do anything about it. They're not taking enough action, I don't think. The past year and a bit, I worked with a production company, and just recently I started freelancing. That's where I'm at now. What got me into filmmaking was taking a program at my high school that was called Hollywood 9. It was half film and half acting. So after I took that class, I just knew being behind the camera is where I wanted to be. I actually specialize in drone work. Whipping out a drone in the forest is like no other. We're going 100 kilometers over trees. It's so surreal. Drone work in Port Moody is unfortunately heading downhill. Everyone started to buy drones, and then the rules got tougher and tougher, and they banned a lot of the parks with drones. I've got a certificate for myself. I'm fully licensed, so I can keep flying. So I'm actually really hoping to talk to the city soon and implement some new rules. And maybe I could be the head of a drone operation in Port Moody and have everyone come to me if they need to get approved for a flight. I think that could be something really cool that Port Moody could work with me on. Port Moody is the city of the arts for a reason, but actually there isn't that big of a filmmaking community here. I feel like we're a small town, but we're getting bigger every day. There's not that many people or names that you hear coming out of Port Moody, but I definitely feel like they have a lot of stories to share here. I'd love to start some sort of event or group that connects everyone here in Port Moody so we can all create and collaborate together. Obviously, the end goal of the freelancer is to network and just expand as much as I can. I feel like Port Moody is kind of this hidden gem that a lot of people don't really come out of the city to see, but there's definitely a lot to offer here. In the filmmaking community, maybe not so much now, but I definitely feel like we could grow a stronger fan base here for sure.
Gaining followers isn't easy, but Nicholas posts to his Instagram daily to a whopping 1,434 followers at the age of 15. Let's take a look at how Nicholas got such a huge following in the small town of Port Moody.
My name is Nico Pavlakos, and I'm a landscape photographer. I'm 15 years old, and I'm from Port Moody, BC. I like to snowboard a lot with my family and all my friends, and the team I'm on, which is Fraser Valley Snowboard Club. I get coached, and we compete in provincials and all kinds of stuff, and that's super fun. And it also relieves stress. I just like something that looks super unique and doesn't look like everything else. So there's lots of basic like portraits and landscapes, but when people take pictures, like one of my favorites is like long exposure pans and then having it on like a 15th of a second and then just panning it across like a view and getting just the colors like spewed across the screen. I've been able to see a lot of other photographers' work and then take what they do and add it into my own photography, especially with their styles and different techniques. I personally like Rocket Point because it doesn't have a lot of crazy like physical like mountains and all kinds of stuff, so it kind of makes you work for a good picture. Like you have to find little things like flowers or grasses and with the sunset in the background because the sunset's over there. I've been going to Rocket Point since I was like really little. I've always lived in Port Moody and I learned how to skateboard and ride BMX at the skate park there and always getting ice cream after. One of my favorite ones I've taken recently was we hiked up to the top of Golden Ears and then spent the night there, and it was super hard hike, so it was super worth it and made the photo even more like rewarding to get. And this was like sunrise on the top of Golden Ears with some wildflowers and a tent. My mom used to take a bunch of pictures and she still does, and I kind of just took her camera and started taking pictures of random things and then just went from there.
Thanks for tuning in. Maybe I'll go grab a beer now. See you next week.